وكذلك أوحينا إليك روحا من أمرنا ما كنت تدري ما الكتاب ولا الإيمان ولكن جعلناه نورا نهدي به من نشاء من عبادنا وإنك لتهدي إلى صراط مستقيم صراط الله الذي له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض ألا إلى الله تصير الأمور.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran, recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأولين والآخرين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise due to Allah, we praise Him and we seek His help. Whomsoever Allah guides is the truly guided one, and whomsoever Allah leads astray, no one can show him guidance. May the best peace and blessings be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And welcome to a new episode of Correct Your Citation. In the beginning of this edition of Correct Your Citation, I would like to deliver to all the viewers and the guests at the studio the good news and the glad tidings, which were narrated in the hadith that is judged as a sound hadith, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said on the day of resurrection, the Quran, which we're studying, will petition Allah to clock Sahib al-Quran. The word Sahib means an intimate friend. And in this condition, this person was considered to be Sahib al-Quran because he used to recite it frequently and very oftenly. So the Quran will petition Allah to clock this person with the garment of honor and dignity and respect on the Day of Judgment. A crown of honor will be placed on the head of the reciter, and the Quran will then petition Allah to shower this person, Sahib al-Quran, with his pleasure. Then Allah the Almighty will become pleased with him, and the reciter will be then ordered and asked to recite. As he recites, he keeps elevating. With every ayah he recites, he shall receive a reward for it. And his rank will be at the last ayah he would end up reciting. Too many beautiful good news to the reciters of the Quran, to the companions of the Quran. May Allah make us all amongst them. In the beginning of this episode as well, I would like to welcome our guests with us at the studio, Brother Abdullah Barira. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And Muhammad Shindi. And finally, our brother Ahmed Basuni. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And welcome to the studio and welcome to a new episode of Correct Your Citation. Let's just refresh our memory and remember together a few things that were discussed in the last episode and the last episodes as well. If you can remind me, Abdullah, with the importance of studying and knowing the articulation points of the Arabic alphabet.
First of all, it allows us to pronounce the Quran properly, to recite the Quran properly. This is the main point, and especially when there is some letters, sometimes we tend not to distinguish the difference between those two letters. For example, the ta and the ta. Mm-hmm. So when we know the points of articulations of each and every letter, this allows us to make the difference within them.
Exactly. So basically, knowing the articulation point makes each letter very distinct from any other letter, even from the letters which are nearby as far as the other articulation points. Exactly. Sometimes we grouped some of the letters together. We said that they have articulation points which are nearby. So we group them and we give them certain names, such as, for instance, we said there is a group of three letters which is called al-huruf al-shajriya, not al-shajariya. Muhammad, can you remind us with the letters which are described as al-huruf al-shajriya?
Al-huruf al-shajriya is three letters, the sheen and the jim, and the ya without which is without prolongation.
You mean the ya which is not a ya mad?
Yeah.
So the same letter could be a regular ya,
yeah,
or could be a ya of a mad letter. Do you know the difference between both of them?
Yes. The ya which is of a mad letter, it comes from the gawf, or
you still insist on pronouncing the jim as gim. You mean the jawf? Okay.
Yes.
So basically, first of all, would like to speak about the vowels.
Yes.
The ya, which is not a ya maddiya, which is not prolonged, has either fatha, dhamma, or kasra, or even a sukun. But the other ya maddiya is a ya sakina, ya with sukun, but it is preceded with a letter, any letter, that has a kasra underneath it. Right?
Yeah.
Such as he, the letter ya is second and it's preceded by a letter ha that has a kasra.
And those three letters is when we say it, we use the bottom, the bottom of the,
you're talking about the al-huruf al-shajriya?
Yeah.
Okay. Why did we call the three letters the sheen and the jim and the ya, which is not a mad ya, we call them together shajriya? Why?
Because we use the bottom of the mouth with the roof of the
bottom of the mouth. Okay, try this once again.
Middle.
Practice it.
The middle of the tongue.
The middle of the tongue.
With the roof of the mouth.
It's correspondent of the roof of the mouth. Right? So basically, shajriya means the middle of the mouth. And we saw the elevation, the change that takes place in the tongue when we came to pronounce the sheen. Today, inshallah, we shall resume with the first letter with us, the letter Sad. Once again, to all the viewers, inshallah, Azza Jal, we'll do our best to finish up all the articulation points in this episode. So afterward, we'll be able to practice what we've learned with the most important surah in the Quran first, Surah Al-Fatiha. Then afterward, as we go by studying the rest of the rules and regulations of Tajweed, we'll practice with Surah Al-Kahf, inshaAllah, Azza wa Jal. The letter Sad, if you remember, we said that there is a group that summons three letters. The Sad is one of them, okay?
Yeah.
And they have very common characteristic, which is?
Is like whistling.
Exactly, it is. So let's see the articulation point of the Sad. Once again, look at the diagram and repeat after me. As, as, as,
as,
as,
as,
as.
Okay. So the letter Sad comes from the tip of the tongue and the palates of the two top front incisors at a point just above the two front lower incisors. That is similar to the Zay and the Sin.
Yes.
So we say Zay, Sin, and Sad are also known as Al-Huruf Al-Asaliyya. And Asaliyya due to the origin of these letters. They all come from Asalat Al-Lisan or Taraf Al-Lisan or the tip of
the tongue.
They're also known as the letters of the whistle because of the sound of the whistle that comes out once we pronounce any of these three letters. Once again, before we move to the next letter, as, as, as,
as,
as,
as.
There is a common mistake in pronouncing these three letters, this group of al-huruf al-asaliyya, which is lack of whistle. And that happens due to the strong overbite. Some people have this overbite. It's kind of strong. So they kill the whistle. It will be treated by adjusting the lower jaw so that it would leave a space so that you will create the whistle sound. As, S, and as. Okay? The first word we have with the examples of the sad, isbiru.
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 الصلاة
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 فأصبح
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 فأصبح.
A very common mistake in pronouncing the صاد is mixing up between the صاد and the سين. And we will get to see that once you start practicing Surah Al-Fatiha. And we will notice that it is a grave mistake for those who make it sometimes unknowingly. Okay, the next letter is the Dad. And I will not be exaggerating if I say that is the most important letter at all. Why? Al-Dad is a very special letter. The Dad has several articulation points. It actually comes from one or both sides of the tongue and from the molars of the gum area next to the molars. So it is kind of difficult, not only for the non-Arabs, but for the Arabs as well. Yeah. So we will check out the first articulation point with the right side of the tongue and what meets it from the gum side or the molars of the gum. The molars and the gum. Watch this. This is the right side of the tongue, the right side of the tongue, and here are the molars. Ab, 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 ab. So basically, the tip of the tongue has nothing to do with pronouncing
al-dad,
but it's involved in pronouncing the dal. Yeah. That's why it's a mistake to confuse the dad with the dal. And this is a very common mistake. So, first, the right side of the tongue, which we call it haffatul lisan. The haffa is the side, whether the right or the left. Ab, ab, ab. And it does not involve the entire side of the tongue. Rather, it's only the posterior side of the tongue. And once it ends here, there will be the beginning of another letter, which is the lam. So remember, only the posterior side of the tongue, along with the molars and the gum area next to the molars, is the articulation point for the dad. Ab, ab, ab. I want you to feel the posterior side of the tongue, of the right side, along with the molars and its gum. Now, from the left side, look at the diagram. Ab, ab, ab. You feel it here, that the posterior side of the left side of the tongue is in contact with the molars and the gums next to the area of the molars. Ab, ab, ab. And the tip of the tongue does not get involved at all.
Yeah.
And we also said that from either side or both sides. So in this condition, we will see that both sides are getting involved in pronouncing this very difficult letter, the dad. Ab, ab, ab. Okay? I would like to hear it from you, Abdullah.
Ab, ab.
So I assume that now you're using both sides, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Muhammad, what about using just the right side of the tongue?
Ab.
Ab. Exactly. The left side, Ahmed.
How we can differentiate between the right side and the left side?
That you tell, because you are the one who's pronouncing this. So you work on it. It requires a lot of practice.
Yes.
Okay? Perhaps you stick your tongue out and outline the side of the tongue and you feel it
when it comes in contact with the molars on that side, we're talking about the posterior side of the tongue. Ab. By the way, that's why they call the Arabic language the language of the blood. Okay?
I'll just try, Sheikh, but I feel it's very hard, I think.
It is.
You have
it
to learn the three ways, Sheikh.
Okay. We say these are three ways. You pronounce it with whichever way suits you better, and it becomes easier for you.
Yes.
But make sure that you don't confuse the blood with the dal.
Yes.
So you don't say, walad dalin, instead of abdalin, and so on. Okay. One more time, the right side, abd. The left side, abd. And both sides of the tongue and the molars and the gum area next to the molars, abd.
Can I try, Sheikh?
Sure.
I feel it's very hard, I think. From the right side, abd.
Make sure that you don't pronounce it as the va, because some people confuse the blood with the va, so yes, they say av.
Yes.
No, that's another letter.
I'm just concentrating.
Yes. Right. So av, yes, not av.
I'm just concentrating to give it out, okay, from the right side. Av.
Exactly, that is right. The second one was right, okay?
Yes.
طيب. And we'll take the examples, then inshallah we'll go for a short break to continue after that. The first word is al-du'afa.
Al-du'afa.
You notice that I'm pronouncing the word of the word fadl from the right side of the tongue. Al-du'alin. Well, let's take a short break, please. Stay tuned. Do not go far away. We'll continue, inshallah, in a couple of minutes. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Welcome to this new episode of Focus Point.
The new generation has the good, the habit of reading more than before.
Jewish question was named basically the problem of Jews who lost their function in society.
Many people trying to get together, but all their efforts were in vain because of ignoring or turning away from this great foundation. We see many people coming to the way of truth, following the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but later on, they get off track. What is the reason behind that? Unity is a result, it's not a cover-up. We have to be united from inside. And Allah made this clear in the Quran when He said, وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولَ.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. I'm going to skip the order of the letters only this time because of the importance of linking the letter Dad in its origin and point of articulation to the letter Lam and comparing between both of them, because both of them actually would use other side of the tongue or the Haffatul Lisan. So that's why when we go to the letter Lam to examine its articulation point, we'll find the following. Al L. We notice that we begin with the lam from the same point where we stopped with the dad. And a very important information here, which is that while the dad is easier to be pronounced from the side of the tongue, the left side of the tongue, with the gum of the molars of the left side, we find the lam, its pronunciation is easier from the right side of the tongue. So, let's look at this diagram. L, L, L. We notice it comes from the anterior one-third of the side of the tongue until the sides end at the tip, from here till here. Then what lies opposite to them of the gums of the two top front incisors, the two top lateral incisors, and the two top canines, and the two top premolars. This whole area, once the dot ended, is the beginning of the articulation point of the lamb. So let's try one more time, L, and try this time from the right side of the tongue. L,
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 L, L.
And compare between L and L. أض أض
أض أض أض أض
then ال
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 ال we notice that the posterior side of the tongue, either the right or the left, is preserved for the dot, while the anterior side or one third of the tongue is for the lamb. And one more comparison, it's easier to pronounce the dot from the left side of the tongue, while it's easier to pronounce the lam from the right side of the tongue. Let's take a few examples. القى
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 لعلكم
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 اللطيف
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 Great. بارك الله فيكم. The next letter after the dot in order was the ta. Okay. The ta along with the ta and the dal are grouped together, and this group of letters are known as الحروف النطعية. We mentioned that before, and we said they were called نطعية due to that the مخرج or the articulation point of these letters close to the elevated area above the gums of the two top front incisors. So how do we pronounce the ta? أط 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 The ta comes from the tip of the tongue with the root of the upper teeth. The tip of the tongue and the roots of the upper teeth. أط أط There is much involvement of the tongue than in the case of the ta. أت أت So make sure we do not confuse these two letters together. There is at and there is at. Yatba and there is yatba. Change in the pronunciation of the ta into ta changes the entire meaning completely. Let's take some examples. Yat'amuh.
Yat'amuh.
يطعمه
يطعمه
الطامة
الطامة
الطلع
الطلع
كالطود
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 When it's these two letters in the same word, the ta
and the dal
كالطود
كالطود
بارك الله فيكم. The next letter is the letter
ظ.
I think the ظ was put together in a group of letters which were called
اللثوي.
الحروف
اللثوية.
Exactly. بارك الله فيك يا عبد الله. الحروف اللثوية, not اللثوية. الحروف اللثوية. Why is that?
Come from the tip of the tongue with the upper teeth.
Because the upper gum.
The gum, yes.
Okay.
The gum is
so the dha is articulated as follow. Av, 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 av. The dha comes from the tip of the tongue and the bottom edges of the two top front incisors. Av, av,
av,
av,
av.
Abdullah. Av,
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 av.
Okay. Let's take a few examples of how to pronounce the dha in a word. Azlamu.
Azlamu.
Normally, when we read any verse in the Quran and we stop at any word, no matter what kind of vowel is on the last letter, we change it into sukun. So we stop at it. So we'll say azlam.
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 Azlam'an.
الظمآن
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 ظالمين
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 ظالمين.
Great. The next letter is a letter which has a group that we already discussed earlier. The letter عين and the following letter as well, which is غين. These two letters, if you remember, we said they are known as الحروف الحلقية because they originate from الحلق. And الحلق means what, يا محمد؟ The throat. Yet we said that the throat has three different articulation points for six letters. Each two letters share one articulation point. So we said there is the farthest side of the throat, the middle, then the nearest.
The nearest.
Okay. We'll come to look at the عين and its exact articulation point comparing to the rest of الحروف الحلقية right now. Okay. The عين along with the حا or the حا come from the middle of the throat. So we say أع
أع
أع أع. By the way, this is one of the most difficult letters for non-Arabs, especially English speakers. I'd like you to say it, Ya Abdallah. Exactly, especially your name begins with the Ayn. Okay. What normally happens is it is mispronounced by non-Arab speakers by saying A.
Yes.
And this is how will they write it in English.
Yeah.
Double A. Okay. A.
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 But Christian... the throat, so that it will come properly. Ah, 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 and remember, it comes from the middle of the throat. Okay, let's take a few examples of that. Wa'ad,
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 wa'ad.
U'budu,
u'budu.
Da'a,
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 da'a.
It's a very interesting letter, and right away when you hear somebody is reading Arabic or saying an Arabic word or name and makes a mistake with this letter, right away you can tell where is he from. When you say Abdullah, right away this person does not speak Arabic. Because it's not Arabic, it is Arabic. Right? Okay. The next letter is the Ghain, and we already took a look at it and we said it comes as well from the throat, but from the nearest part of the throat. The nearest to what? The nearest to the mouth.
Yeah.
And the farthest from the makhraj of the hams and the ha. Okay? So, adna al-halq, the nearest part of the throat, the nearest to the mouth, is the makhraj and the articulation point for two letters, the ghain and the kha. So, the ghain comes from the closest part of the throat to the mouth. Agh.
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 Agh. And once again, that's another letter where you can easily differentiate between the Arabs and the non-Arabs, or a person who knows how to recite the Quran and others through hearing them saying this letter. What do normally people say if they don't know Arabic? They will say ag.
Yes.
Pronounce the ghain as gh instead.
Yeah.
Okay. So we say Chicago, while in Arabic we say Chicago.
Chicago.
Exactly. Okay. The fa. So now before we go to the fa, remember there is a group of six letters which we call them al-huruf al-halqiyya.
Yes.
Because they all come from the halq. It is true that they are distributed throughout the halq. Some are farthest, some are middle, some are the nearest or the closest to the mouth. Yet all of them are considered as hurufun halqiyya.
Yeah.
What are they once again, Muhammad?
The al-huruf al-halqiyya. Al-hamz.
Al-hamz.
Wa al-ayn. Al-hamz wa al-ha.
Exactly.
Wa al-ayn wa al-ha.
Wa al-ha.
Wa al-ha. Wa al-ha.
الغين والخاء.
Actually, putting them in this order is easier because we're going to use them further in the ahkam. In addition to when you say, oh, al-hamz wal-ha, these two letters come from where?
The forest.
The farthest
far
part of the throat.
Of the throat.
Hamz wal-ha.
Yeah.
Okay. Then right after that is
al-ayn
wal-ha.
Wal-ha.
Okay. Yes. Normally we say Muhammad. Not ha.
Not Muhammad.
Okay, exactly. So it will be a' and ah from the middle part of the throat. Then finally, the closest part of the throat to the mouth is the makhraj or the articulation point for two letters. The ghain and the kha. These six letters we put in a group and called
الحلقية.
الحروف الحلقية. Exactly. Barakallahu fikum. What about this letter? The fa. Very interesting letter. The fa is articulated from between the inside of the lower lip and the tip or the edges of the two top front incisors. Okay, watch this. F. So the edges of the two top front incisors would almost come in contact, not completely. F to the inside part of the lower lip. So the fa is articulated from between the inside of the lower lip and the tips or the edges of the two top front incisors. Look at it.
F.
So you're going to take the lower lip, draw it back so that it will come right beneath the upper front incisors or the edges of the upper front incisors.
F.
Okay, great. Take some examples.
Aftara.
Saffa.
Aflaha.
Unfortunately, we're running out of time, and I think that we're due to take a short break, so please stay tuned. We'll get back to you in a couple of minutes. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Dear viewers, in the winter of our age, that is when we get older, and that is when we need our most support. That is when we feel least secure. And luckily for these gentlemen around me, they have someone to look after them in their old age. They have some support and some love. Unluckily for most of their citizens who are old in the Gaza Strip, and due to the daily Israeli closures and bombings, a lot of these elderly citizens don't have this luxury where they can get food, where they have a bed to sleep on. And this is what we will try and show you today, the hardships and the support that some of these people get.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. In the next few minutes, the remaining part of this episode, we'll try our utmost to wrap up all the articulation points and the remaining part of them. We finished in the last segment with the letter fa, and we recognize the involvement of the lip, the lower lip, with the edges of the top front incisors. That's why the letter fa, along with other three letters, which is the ba, the meem, and the waw. So basically, four letters, the ba, the fa, the meme, and the waw. These letters together were put in a group and were called الحروف الشفوية, from the شفا or the lip, because they share in their origin the lips. So we call them الشفوية. Now, the common two letters are close to each other in the مخرج and were put together in one group. And right away, we'll get to know why these two letters, only these two letters, were put together in this group and what name were they given. Let's first take the letter قاف. We put the Hamza before the قاف, then we applied سكون on it, and now we're ready to pronounce it. And we'll come to say أق
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 أق. There are several changes that take place in the mouth. The farthest side of the tongue is elevated, and there is a move in the uvula. That's why the قاف and the كاف together were put in a group by themselves, and they were called الحروف اللهوية, because of this uvula, this conical tissue which is hanging from the middle of the soft palate. So أق
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 أق.
I'm repeating over and over because some people make mistakes and they mix up between the قاف and the كاف.
Yes.
And these are two different letters. So why do we mix up sometimes between the قاف and the كاف? Because the كاف is very nearby in its origin to the قاف.
Yes.
With the exception that the قاف is further away from okay. the كاف. And the كاف is nearer to the mouth cavity or to the mouth from the قاف. So if we say the قاف comes here, then the كاف is ahead of it. Okay. The قاف is articulated from the deepest part of the tongue, and what lies opposite to it from the roof of the mouth in the area of the soft palate. Okay, that is the قاف. And we don't really have to go to take the slide of the كاف. Rather, it will be enough to point that the كاف comes from here. If the قاف comes from there, then the كاف comes from here. So we'll say أق for the قاف and أك أك for the كاف. Abdullah, أك
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 أك أكل تو
أكل تو
أكل تو
أكل تو.
While the other one is أق
أق
is further away from the كاف. Let's take a few examples. Oh, the very first word in the entire Quran, in the revelation.
Yes.
اقرأ. Read. اقرأ.
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 الحق.
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 اقسم.
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 Of course, the طاء is very famous along with other letters. They're known as حروف القلقلة.
Yeah.
There is a very specific characteristic that they share. These letters are the قاف, the طاء, the باء, the جيم, and the داء. There are five of them.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll come to study this ruling in details, inshallah, whenever it is due. But this is just by the way, as long as we're talking. Okay. Now we said the قاف and the كاف. We studied them already. Let's take the لام.
Yeah.
I thought we already studied the لام.
Yeah.
Right. When we compare between
the lamb and both,
the lamb and the dot, as far as what? As far as that one begins at the end of the articulation point of the other.
Yes.
So the dot takes the posterior side, then
the lamb
takes the anterior one third of the side of the tongue.
It is easy,
right?
For the dot to say it from the right side and for the lamb to say it from the left side.
I think you switched. You mixed up. The dot is easier to be pronounced from which side, the Abdullah?
From the left side.
Left side.
Yeah.
Okay. And the lamb from?
Right side.
The right side.
Yeah.
Okay. Then the letter meem. We just said that the ba, the fa, the meem, and the waw are put together in a group and called al-huruful al-shafawiyya or al-shafahiyya. So basically, we expect the meem to play with the lips. And this is exactly what will happen. أم أم
أم.
Okay, the change which take place is on between the lips. أم 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 articulated by closing the two lips together. The ميم is articulated by closing the two lips together. أم
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 أم.
I would like you to remind me with the articulation point of the فاء.
The فاء is exactly the same.
Exactly the same.
Except I mean the articulation point, but the only difference is that we move.
In the case of the فاء, the upper lip doesn't work with us. What works with us is the edges of the
yeah.
top two front incisors resting on the middle or the inside of the lower lip.
Yes.
You say F,
S,
F,
S,
F, F.
True.
Right?
Yeah.
But the meme, there is a complete اطباق,
yeah.
or closing of the lips.
The two lips.
M.
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 Muhammad.
Muhammad.
Exactly. Okay. صلى الله عليه وسلم. أمن.
أمن.
وتمت
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 لما
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 لما, لما.
Okay, the next letter is the noon, and we already discussed that the noon, the lam and the ra together were put in a group, and this group were called الحروف الذلقية. The two, their origin come from the tip of the tongue, right? Remember,
yeah.
N, R, and L. Now, examining exactly the articulation point of the noon by putting fatha on the hamza before, then putting sukun on the noon, then pronouncing, and once the sound ceases. That is exactly the makhraj or the articulation point of the noon. An.
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 I just love this diagram because it shows me exactly where does the letter come from. And it is moving. So the tip of the tongue and what lies opposite to it from the gum of the two front top incisors. Again. An. Not
an.
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 An. Exactly. Okay. Inna.
Inna.
An-nur.
An-nur.
Tamanna.
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 I'm sure one of you is going to ask, why do we pause on the noon? Of course, we'll come to study the Ghunna and its related rules and regulations, inshallah, once we're done with this. The next letter is the Ha, and I don't think we have to spend any much time with it anymore because we already recognize that the Hams and the Ha come from where?
The
farthest side of the throat, which is Aqsa al-Halq. Ah.
Ah.
Here. Ah.
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 That's an easy letter for everybody to say. Okay. The letter waw, it's still amongst al-huruf al-shafawiyya,
yeah.
because of the involvement of the lip. We say
aw.
So the waw is articulated by forming a circle of the two lips without the two lips meeting completely. So there is an air stream coming out of the mouth through the two lips. Aw.
Aw.
Aw. You form a circle.
Yes.
With the two lips, without closing the two lips. Aw.
Aw.
Aw. Great. Okay. Of course, in some other languages, people mispronounce the waw, and instead they say tha. And instead of wa, they say tha. Or we, they say thee.
Yeah.
So make sure that the waw is different than any other letter. And the waw in Arabic is very distinct. And that's why we say أول
أول
not أول أول
أول
أول
أول
you make sure you form a circle with the two lips, the upper and the lower, without closing them. There is an air stream that comes out of them. أول
أول
أولى
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 تولوا
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 okay last but not the least, of course, last letter of the regular letters. Because afterward we'll study the mad letters inshallah azza wa jal. The last letter is the ya. And we already spoke about the ya before. And the ya is articulated from the middle of the tongue and what lies opposite to it from the roof of the mouth. So would you remind us, Muhammad, this letter ya is put in a group with another two letters and they were all together named what? Al-huruf
al-shajriyah.
Al-shajriyah, exactly. Barakallahu feek.
Dr. Shajara in Arabic means
a tree, but this is not a shajara.
No, I mean shajara means cut from the middle.
No, شجرة with a vowel فتحة on the جيم is different than شجرة. In this case, we're talking about the شجرة, which is the middle of the mouth. So when we say the letters which are شجرية, because they come from the middle
of the mouth.
Of the mouth. It has nothing to do with the tree.
Yeah.
Okay? So now, أي أي
أي
أي
أي,
أي. Okay. Shay-in.
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 Okay. When we stop, we'll say shay.
Yes.
Shay.
Shay.
Ayyam.
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 Samiyya.
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 You know what, brothers and sisters and dear guests at the studio? We came a very long way. We finally finished all the articulation points. This is a very important step on the right track of learning how to recite the Quran properly. It might seem to many of the viewers, this is a very boring part. I understand that. But without it, you can never learn how to recite the Quran properly. Whether you are an Arab or a non-Arab, you must go through this part first so that you'll be able to pronounce the letters and accordingly the words properly. And everything takes time and takes effort. But this effort is a very, very blessed effort. Because every minute you are spending, you're receiving a reward for that. We finally ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to teach us what we don't know. And to help us to understand what we have studied and learned. And practice properly. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. Before I forget, the next episode inshallah is a very, very important one. In the next episode, inshallah, we'll get to practice together how to recite Surah Al-Fatiha properly. This very important, no, the most important surah in the entire Quran. I'll leave you fi amanillah. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle. Recite the Quran, recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. We were chosen to be part of his nation. He gave us a message, and that was Islam. So read this miracle, recite the Quran.